guys, episode 9. Oh my goodness, so many exciting things about to happen in this episode. I'm literally so excited to show you all the wonderful things. Our song today is Don't Give Up On Me. So literally, what a better expression and notion and theme for today and really any day over the past few weeks than Don't Give Up On Me. So I'm super pumped. You're gonna hear some great things from Mrs. Holloway, and you're actually gonna get to meet one of our incredible special guests. I'm so excited for you guys, and this is gonna be great. You guys, let's do this!
Hi guys, vlog number 9. Oh my gosh, I can't believe it. We're almost done, that's crazy. We're so proud of you. You guys have been working so hard, so awesome job. Love seeing all your comments on the Google Classroom and just seeing that the fact that the videos have been viewed so many times tells us that you guys are working hard, so great job. Don't give up on me. I love this song. I feel like since even the days of you guys just like learning the song, you knew what it was about and you knew how important the message of the song was. I think the first time I heard you guys sing it, I cried. So, right? So I think you've succeeded in understanding the emotion of the song and the beauty of the song. Stick with that and don't let that get away from you. You know, I think this was probably the first full song that we knew as a whole. Don't kind of toss it aside like, oh yeah, I know this one, like I'll practice something else. Keep practicing it so it still keeps that just that sincerity about it. The song is so beautiful. I think this is probably the one I miss you guys singing the most. I love it, and I think you guys just get it, and I love that. So keep practicing, have so much fun. And we will see you back here tomorrow for the last one. Oh, that's crazy. I love you. Have a great day. We miss you. Everything I've said every day. And yeah, see you tomorrow. Love you. Bye.
Oh, hey guys, I didn't see you there. I'm just casually, you know, listening to some Mrs. Holloway. Oh my gosh, you guys take a listen. Listen to how like clear her voice is. Yes. Best of them. The rest of them. Guys, how magical is she? Let's warm up, shall we? All right. Let's do a nice ooh today. So it's gonna be ooh, ready, and. Thank you. ready, end. Don't Give Up On Me. In this song, there's only one female solo, and that is Miss Tegan. So Tegan will obviously start with your solo. I'll play through Jack's, and then I'll teach you yours. And then the rest of this, we know. This whole song, we've gone over. You guys learned this and memorized it in 1 month, which is a record at Nellie Bennett School. You learned it, memorized it, and had it done by January 30th. Amazing. So this is just a review. Again, this is Don't Give Up On Me. So from the beginning, Jack sings. And then Tegan sings. And Tegan, I want you to sing up here. And I will stay. It's a little high for me, but you could definitely do it. So, and I will stay. Here we go, Tegan. This is 1, 2, 3. And then you'll come back down for Like Lovers Do. So again, that's just Tegan. Tegan, you sing the... Everyone comes back in for I'll Reach My Hand Out. So everyone, Tegan just sang, like lovers do. Everyone, and I'll reach. Thank you. but this is still Ben singing. So you guys, again, you really know this. You really just sing the chorus both times, and then we sing the ending together, which is really, really nice. The important thing to think about when you're practicing this is make sure you're singing all the right pitches, as per usual, all the right words. For example, yet comes before me. What I mean is, because I'm not giving up, no, not yet. Me is the second time you sing it. So just keep that in mind. Make sure you know the words, the pitches, and really make sure that your emotion and energy, which I'm sure Mrs. Holloway is talking about, is going to be put into this song. So really think about the way you're acting it and the way you're singing it. And you want to make sure your voice matches the feelings that the composer put into the music. Knock it out of the park. Gentlemen! Hey, how's it going? All right, so we are doing Don't Give Up on Me. Super pumped about it. As I mentioned earlier, this is something you guys have already broken traditions with. You have learned it, memorized it, and pretty much perfected it all within a month in January. Crazy. So super pumped about that. We're going to go over the two solos for Jack and Ben in this song. So as we go through it, I'll stop and we'll teach that and you guys will know what's going on and then you'll be good to go and we'll start practicing that more and getting more comfortable with it. But the biggest thing with this song is boys, just remember for the most part, you have the harmony. So don't sing the melody. Don't do it. Okay. I'm just going to back this up a little bit. Okay. All right, here we go. So let's start from the beginning. Jack Attack. You start us out. So you sing, I will fight for you. I always do until my heart is black and blue. So that is just you, my friend. Let's do it from the beginning again with just you singing. So we have.
Thank you.
also just been. So then we go back, and now you sing by yourself. I'll reach my hands out in the dark. Right there, I got added to the page really fast. Ben, so just to be clear, you're singing and I will hold, so it's 3, 4, 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. And then we go back, but just Ben sings. Whoa, lost my music. Just Ben sings, I'll reach. Okay, and then you'll hold it out a little bit and then you'll be good. So Ben sings, I'll wait for you. Ben sings. Then everyone sings, cause I. Okay, so make sure you guys listen to a few things. One, Jack and Ben, just make sure you listen to your parts so you know when you're singing, what you're singing, all that good stuff. Everyone else, make sure the two things. One, always sing the harmony. Don't sing the melody. The girls got it. Don't worry about it. So always sing the harmony and always make sure, I kind of said this before, but always make sure you're singing the exact same words and pitches as everyone else, but make sure your emotion is matching what you're singing in this, and then you'll be ready to roll. All right, let's put it together.
Hi, everyone. My name is Mr. Kearns. I am the stagecraft teacher at Point Pleasant Borough High School. I'm also the director of the fall play and spring musical. In stagecraft, we build the scenery for all of the plays, lighting design, and set up for band concerts, choral concerts, everything that happens over at the Lauren Donnelly Center for the Performing Arts. As a director and a performer myself, I want to share some tips with you as performers. We always love to bring parts of our shows to the elementary school because you guys are such great performers. You're always enthusiastic. And so, such a great audience and make us feel great about our chance to perform and practice and share our work with you. And as you know, whenever an actor has to sing a song, whenever a performance is singing, they have to emote and they have to act out the song as well as singing it. You want to sound great, make sure that you're on pitch, and that you're at the right tempo, but you also want to make sure that you're telling the story of the song, all right? In musical theater, songs tell so much in such a short amount of time, so we need to know if we're happy, if we're sad, if we're angry, if we're really excited, so we have a lot to do. And the best way to do that is to know what your lyrics mean. I always suggest to any performers to go through their song and circle words they don't know. Figure out what those words mean. And write down, right on the side of their sheet music, what am I trying to say here? Am I happy? Am I sad? Am I going to be too loud here or too soft? What am I supposed to be doing in each moment of the song? Always write it down as a way to help you. Another thing you can do with your lyrics is write them in your own words. all right? If you were pretending to sing as a character in a musical, how would you say these thoughts and these actions? How would you tell your story in your own words? Doesn't have to be as long as the song, can be really short, but how would you do it? Always write it out in your own words and then find a way to act that out as a monologue. And singers and performers that work in theater will also not just sing their song, but just speak it. Speak it like they're telling a story, telling a monologue. Still with those same actions, all right? Still big and loud when they have to be, or excited. But they won't sing and not worry about how they sound, not worrying about the notes, just worrying about the words. And if they understand the words, their audience is going to understand what they're singing about later on in their performance. So I would encourage anyone to take a song and act it out without singing it, share it with a family member or a friend, and get their feedback. What do they tell you? Do they understand what you're saying? And it never hurts to ask for help. If you don't know what a word means, if you don't know what action you're supposed to be playing, all right, get that song up on its feet. And then the next time you go to perform it and sing it with the music, it'll be 10 times better. I guarantee it. So remember, keep acting, keep singing, keep living your best life. Be happy. Take care.
Okay, fam, here we go. Don't give up on me all the way through. I'm going to play a little bit of your parts, but more so of the piano part, because I think you guys really know this song extremely well. I want you to think of just one thing while you're singing this. I said this a few times already, but I want you to think about the emotion that you're putting into this song. You want it to sound just like the way the composer intended it, with the lyrics and the music. You want your voice and your face to match what that person is asking for. So make sure you really read the lyrics, read the words, and make sure you're familiar and make sure you're understanding of what you need to do as a performer. And just keep that in mind. And honestly, you're gonna sound so beautiful on this. Again, everyone watching, the fans out there, you guys, you have no idea. This is like crazy. And it's not even as hard. It's so impressive because it's so beautiful the way that it sounds. And I'm really proud of it. So you guys keep up the good work. Let's sing it all together. I'll try and call out the solos and hopefully I don't lose any pages along the way. All right, here we go. Don't give up on me from the beginning, starting with Jack. Thank you. really, really, really enjoy practicing that over the next few days, few weeks, week, month. Who knows? Enjoy practicing that. The biggest thing, like I said, really listen to the music, really listen to the dynamics that we put in. If you remember them, really make sure you remember them. I tried to implement them as much as possible on a keyboard, but you know, that's always so interesting to try and do. But this is a really special song, and you guys deserve to sing this the way you've been practicing it, because it's honestly remarkable the way you sing it. And I know that if anyone hears you at home singing it, they're gonna be like, because it's so good. It's that good. So again, practice, listen to the pitches, don't forget the dynamics, don't forget the meaning and the expression of the song, and really enjoy it, you guys. All right, you rock.